Security CTFs or capture flag competitions have nothing to do with paintball or shooter games, but they are awesome to learn hacking. They can be very challenging and teach you a lot of new skills. In this video, I want to tell you about what kind of challenges there are and how you can find CTFs to play. Generally, there are two categories of CTFs, Jeopardy style and attack and defense. While the second one sounds like a lot of fun, personally I have never played one, so I will only focus on the Jeopardy style, especially because it's easier to get into. So a typical CTF offers a bunch of different challenges that you have to solve. Most commonly, you have to exploit some kind of servers, so you get remote access to the server so you can then read the content of a file that contains a special string, the flag, which is proof that you hacked the system. You can then enter the string in a form and you get points depending on how hard the challenge was for your team. Usually, a challenge has a title, a short description, and maybe infos on how to reach the servers or a file to download. Oftentimes, the title or description is already a small hint. So for example, here was a challenge called SHA-1L code at the HitCon CTF 2014, and without really looking into the challenge, I already assumed that you have to write shellcode and it has to do something with SHA-1 hashes, maybe writing shellcode in the form of SHA-1 hashes. And indeed, that was the solution in the end. There are a lot of different kinds of challenges, but the typical topics covered are reversing, pwning, crypto, web, and maybe MISC or programming. Reversing usually comes with an executable, a program you can download and run locally. The program implements some kind of algorithm that checks an input key. If you find the correct key, which is oftentimes already the correct flag, then you solved it. So solving it requires you to reverse engineer and understand the implemented algorithm to deduct the correct input key. A good example for that is my Zwiebel video write-up. For pwning challenges, you often get also an executable, but with it an IP address and port of a server running this program. So you have to figure out how to exploit the program to gain remote code execution. You develop your exploit locally and then use it against the server where you can then read the flag file. These challenges range from simple buffer overflows to very advanced heap feng shui stuff, and they are the most interesting ones to me. The cookbook challenge video write-up on my channel is one example of such a challenge. Crypto, like the name says, is about cryptography. Sometimes it's about attacking self-made cipher or very simple crypto attacks like weak random generators. But it can also get really advanced and mathematical, where you are basically lost if you are not up to date with the research and papers from that field. I have a simple video write-up from the Internetwache CTF that gives you an idea, but there are way more advanced ones where I just yield. You should check out Hellman's write-ups. Web challenges are also clear. They are about web applications. Usually, you get a URL and you have to exploit maybe an advanced SQL injection or bypass authentication, sometimes even XSS or CSRF challenges. I also have a web challenge write-up where you can get a feeling for what it is about. MISC basically covers anything else, and programming is also self-explanatory. Mostly it's about clever implementations of solving some kind of problem. Now that you are excited about solving some of these challenges, let's talk about where you can find them. The best platform for all of this is CTF Time. It's made by the CTF community for the CTF community. You can see which CTFs are coming and you get information like format, when it happens and where to register. You can also see the archive of competitions in the past, so for example the HitCon CTF recently, and below you see the final ranking of all teams. Each CTF has points attached to it. Hard CTFs have high numbers like 50 or 75 points, easy CTFs have maybe only 5 or 10 points you can get for them. So if you participate in a very hard CTF and do well, you are rewarded with more than 4 easy college CTFs where you can easily get rank 1. But those CTFs are also really damn hard. At least I struggle a lot with them. Over the year, the CTF teams collect these points and have an overall ranking. Being in the top 50 is quite challenging. But how to find a team? Well, it's like finding a group of friends. There is no one way how to do it. I found my group from another security competition I participated in, and we kept hanging around an IRC and started playing other CTFs. And suddenly, we had a serious team. Before that, I played CTF solo, which meant I would maybe solve only one challenge per CTF, but that's fine. I can't compete with crazy skilled people anyway, and I just play for my own curiosity. But you could also check out the Reddit CTF team open to all, which is, like the name says, open to everybody. But all these CTFs are usually short. They are over a weekend, maybe 48 to 72 hours. But there are also websites where these kind of challenges are available forever. So I played a lot on W3 Charles, Smash a Stack and Over the Wire. In the beginning you will realize you know nothing. You fail every challenge you try, but that's normal. So what I always do, I will look up the challenge after the event, because people create write-ups or upload the exploit script. And then you can work through those solutions. You can research topics you didn't know about. You see how other people solve it and you start gain experience. And you will see that after a couple of CTFs you start to be able to make progress yourself. So for that purpose you should look up the write-ups on CTF Time or the CTF write-up GitHub repository, maybe contribute yourself gathering other people's write-ups and create a pull request, or simply hang around on the IRC channel of the competition because people will start discussing solutions afterwards. I hope this quick overview was helpful to get into challenges yourself, and maybe consider recording yourself solving them during the CTF. Just make sure you don't beg for flags, solutions and hints. Respect the competition, be excellent to each other, and accept your lack of skill and convert it into motivation to learn more.